is wrong and my Bible is right, you better know what you're talking about. The boys be riding them bicycles, read that Bible every day. They be missionaries on a trip, and listen, when they come to your house and you're not ready, you will be going to the Mormon church and leaving St. John. And that preacher don't know what he's talking about. The Mormon guy told me really what's in the Bible. First test you have to take is what I call the bibliographical test. And this is not on your handout. Sorry, Sister Kimberly, I didn't give you this. But I'll make sure you get it for them this week. This is what the bibliographical test says. It says the Bible is a reliable book. And any test that's taken to authenticate books, the bibliographical test lets us know the distance or the time period between the original copies and any manuscripts from those copies, or copies from the original. For example, if you wrote a letter 70 years ago, and I found it under a tree tomorrow, and you're still living, and you can validate that you wrote that letter, that makes it authentic. Amen. So the time period between the original copies of the Bible, by the way, there are no more original copies of the Bible. No way. But we have extant manuscripts that are in close proximity. And I'll tell you about that in just a moment. In other words, since we do not have original documents, how reliable are the copies that we claim to be the Word of God? And so the bibliographical test says you have to look at the distance between the original copies and the first copy that was made off of those. When the Bible was being written, here is how it happened. Paul talks about it to the Corinthians. He says this way, I pass on to you what was handed down to me. In other words, Paul was born after Jesus, born again after Jesus had died, rose again, and gone to heaven. Well, for Paul, if you read the Bible very carefully, he took some trips to Jerusalem. He hung out with Peter and James and the guy. Well, while Paul was there, he used his journalistic ability to write down some things that they shared with him that took place in the life of Jesus when he was alive. And so you notice when he writes to the Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 15, he said, these are the things that I'm handing down to you that was told to me by the apostles. You remember he shared in 1 Corinthians 11 about the Lord's Supper. Was he there when the Lord's Supper was listened to? No, he wasn't. But he was sharing what the men who were there had shared with him on that same night when Jesus was betrayed. He took bread and broke it. Well, did he get that? Someone had to tell him. And so he began to compile letters. You know what the letters are? Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, many don't believe it was that, but 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, all of those letters Paul comprised. And Paul took information from others in order to write under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit the things that God had given him to write. The bibliographical test looks at the ancient manuscripts of the Bible and asks whether the text of the Bible we have today is the same as the original. When you compare, watch this, what we have for the Bible with, we'll say, with what we have in terms of manuscripts from other important works of antiquity, like Plato, okay, or Thucydides. Listen, it's a striking difference in their works, their copies, and ours. For example, the Bible has over 5,000 Greek manuscripts, hundreds of papyri, almost 350 Syriac copies, most dating to the 400th AD. On top of this, virtually the entire New Testament could be reproduced from quotations of the early church fathers. This was around AD 300. Many of these manuscripts are staggeringly accurate. Carolina. He found fragments that date around A.D. 120. Now, A.D. 120 wasn't long after Jesus left. Jesus left here around A.D. 33, 34. So it wasn't more than about 70, 80 years that these fragments that they found off of original copies were extant. That means in existence. And so these manuscripts are very important for the validation of what we call the Bible. Oh, I'm gonna make you shout in a minute. Second of all, you need the external evidence. Not only the bibliographical test of the Bible. I mean, there are not books that have the closeness and proximity from originals to extant copies like the Bible. None in the world. Not one in the entire world. The external evidence simply means you have to find something outside of the book that you consider to be authentic, and it supports your position on its authenticity. Now, let me share this with you. The number of manuscripts and the short length of time between the original manuscript and our first copy. There are certain men in the field called apologetics. What they do is they defend the faith. They're like Sister Calloway, they're like lawyers. They defend our belief system. One is by the name of Norman Geisler. Geisler says there are 5,366 manuscripts to compare and draw information from. To put that in perspective, listen to this. Listen to this. There are only 643 copies of Homer's Iliad. 5,366 manuscripts of the New Testament compared to only 643 manuscript copies of Homer's Iliad. And that is the most famous book in ancient Greece. Homer's Iliad. No one doubt the existence, or do you, of Caesar's Gallic Wars. You've heard about that book. Listen, we only have 10 copies of it, and the earliest of those was made 1,000 years after it was written. And they found extant copies of the Bible about 100 years after it was written. And we'll pick up Caesar's Gallic Wars, read it, pass it on to our children, and use it as historical accounts of the past. Now you get a moment and say, tell me how old your book is. It was written by Joseph Smith, and they still don't have an original copy. Tell the Jehovah's Witnesses to find the originals of their translations and how many have been changed, how many stories have been changed over the lives of those documented. Josh McDowell, another apologist, says there are now more than 5,686 known Greek manuscripts of the New Testament. I'll tell you why I'm saying this. Because we are forming relationships, as our vision says, through the word of God. And we need to know that our word is worth standing on. Do I have a witness here? Listen, you add to the 5,366 known Greek manuscripts, 1,000 or better yet, 10,000 Latin Vulgate and 9,300 of other early versions. We have close to more.